Opinion polls may tell us what people think, but what do they feel? Fear, hope, and humiliation are the three basic mass emotions that influence election results, but may provoke uprisings, riots, or even wars. Only well-informed societies can achieve great things. In this studio, we discuss the main political issues and measure mass emotion of an entire nation in real time.
The thermometer of human emotions is the invention of the world-known journalist and talk show host, Savick Schuster. Over his 30-year career, Savick Schuster covered military conflicts in Afghanistan, Russia, and other post-Soviet states, Africa and Latin America. He's witnessed revolutions and coups. Researcher of mass behavior and humanists, Savick Schuster wondered what drives the masses at a deep level. Why does a nation overthrow a leader it glorified just recently? Why does power suddenly go to the most unlikely people? The answer is mass emotions. Savick Schuster realized that the study of mass emotions can be the key to understanding what is really happening. Therefore, his talk show, Freedom of Speech, became the world's first continuous study of mass emotions. Savick's studio audience should be a sociological portrait of the country. Men, women, right and left, rich and poor, residents of cities and small towns. Politicians and public figures discuss issues in real time, while the emotional reaction of the studio audience is measured and shown on interactive screens. This way, the TV audience and politicians themselves can see how the entire country reacts in real time, together. Top politicians, members of parliament, government officials, and even presidents began to perceive the show as a public platform where their ideas receive instant feedback. Along with high ratings, this led to difficulties. The show survived several politically motivated cancellations. However, its popularity, along with a sense of truthfulness, constantly returned the program to the air. Today, Freedom of Speech is being broadcast in primetime by one of the largest TV channels in Ukraine, and it is hard to imagine a more appropriate country. Our resistance to Russian military aggression and close connection with American events have brought emotions to the forefront in politics and government. The best example of effective application of mass emotion took place in Ukraine. An actor, Vladimir Zelensky, correctly interpreted people's demand for hope, one of the three basic mass emotions. First, Zelensky played a president of the people in his popular TV sitcom, and then won the presidential election in real life. Ukraine's aggressive neighbor, Russia, is also trying to control mass emotions by directing a stream of fear and humiliation at the Ukrainian people in an attempt to restore Soviet Union 2.0. Freedom of Speech is not only a ratings hit, it is actively improving democracy and bringing people into the political life of the country. Today, the attention of the whole world is drawn to the political life of the United States. In the era of digital media and the heyday of informational manipulation, the study of mass emotions becomes especially important. We invite the world to join the study of mass emotions and search for the truth.
People don't lie about their feelings. Truth unites and will help you to know the truth.
Find out more at www.omf.fund.